Begin on the Mishnah towards the bottom of Taf Lamed Gimel Lamed Beis. Zog Teilige Mishnah, Arava, Gezula, a stolen Arava, Vyevesha, a dry Arava, Psula, are possible for the mitzvah. Shalasheira, Vishal Irani Dachas, an Arava that comes from an Avedah Zarah tree or a city that is a Irani Dachas, that everything has to be burnt, Psula is also possible. Nikdam Reisha, if the top of the Arava is cut off, Nifritzu Alev, if most of the leaves are torn off, V'hatzaftzefa, and a tzaftzefa, which is a similar mean to an arava, but it has a different shape, as the Gemara will explain. Psula is also possible. Kemusha, if it's slightly dried. V'shenoshru, miktsasala, and only some of its leaves fell off. V'shalbal, and a luluv that grows in a field that's not near water, and it's not irrigated by water, it just relies on rainwater. Ksheira is also kosher. Rashi points out, even though most of this Mishnah, that it says by Arava and Adasim and Lulav, is a similar halachas of Gzula, Yevesha, Niktam Reisha, and really it could have said all of them together. But because there are specific chidushim by each one, the Mishnah separated them. Over here there's the halacha of Tzaftzefa and Baal, that is not relevant, Benigeta, Adasim, and by each one there was a specific chidush, so therefore it separated them. The Torah describes the aravis as the aravis that grow by a nachal, by a brook. Hagdelim ala nachal. So this is the aravis that grow on a brook. So as Rashi explains, this braisa doesn't mean to say that you must take aravis only those that actually grow by the nachal, but he's just telling you what they are, that l'chatchila the mitzvah is to take from arvi nachal, but you can take any other aravis and you yetzer the mitzvah. Dovacher, another pshat, arve, nachal means sha'ale shalo moshuch kenachal. The shape of the actual leaf of the arava itself is long and drawn out like a stream of water. Tanya doch, in another braisa we learned, arve nachal, the Torah says arve nachal. So seemingly the aravas have to be growing by the nachal. So ainli elo arve nachal. So I only know that arovas that grow by the nachal could be used for the mitzvah. Shel baal v'shel hore minayin. How do I know arovas that grow in a field that's not even irrigated at all by water, just rainwater? V'shel horem, they grow on mountains, minayin. How do I know that it's kosher for the mitzvah as well? Talmud loimar arvei nachal mikol mokim. The Torah uses the term arvei, a plural term, to tell me that all different types of arovas, whether it actually grows by the nachal, it does not actually grow by the nachal, either way, it's going to be kosher. Abishol loimer, Abishol has a different drasha for the fact that the Torah says arvei loshen rabin. Arvei shtayim, arvei refers to two different mitzvahs of arava. Achas lululiv. One is the mitzvah that you take it together with the lulav, the mitzvah of dalad minim. And va'achas lemikdosh, there's another mitzvah of arava that was brought in the Beis HaMikdosh, and they took the arava and they went around the mizbeach with this arava, as we'll see later in the next pedik. So that's why it says arve loshen rabim. V'rabbanon, now according to the Rabbanon, lemikdosh minalahu, from where does he know this halacha of the arava that was brought in the Beis HaMikdosh? According to the Rabbanon, that's a halacha l'mayishim misinai, it's not learned from the pasuk. Ravasi said in the name of Rav Yechanan, there were three halacha l'mayishim misinai that were taught together. The halacha of Esen etiyos, this is a halacha in connection to Shemitah. When it comes to Shemitah, there's a halacha of Taisvis Shemitah. 30 days from before Shemitah, we happen to be right now within 30 days of Ashnasa Shemitah, so 30 days within the Shemitah, is not allowed to do any of the melachas that you're not allowed to do on Shemitah. However, when it comes to netiyos, which are saplings, these young trees, that if you're not going to plow around them and make sure that it shouldn't dry up, so then they're going to die. So for these netiyos, so esa netiyos, if you have 10 of these young trees that are in an area of a beisa, that's 50 by 50 amos, and these 10 trees are distributed in this area with equal amount of space between them. So the halacha l'mayishim misinai tells us that over here we know that these trees are getting their nourishment from the entire ground in this area. And therefore you're allowed to plow this area to make sure that it remains irrigated, that it remains moist, in order for these trees, these new trees, not to die. That's the halacha l'moshe Mishinai of Esa Netiyos. But this is specifically for younger trees. For older trees, this doesn't apply. And if they're not equally distributed in this area, so then you have to measure accordingly each tree, how much it needs for it to not die. And only in that area are you allowed to plow and irrigate it. Arave, then there's the halacha l'moshe Mishinai we're speaking about here, which is the arave brought by the Mizbeach and the Beis HaMikdash. V'nisach HaMayim. And the third thing is Nisach HaMayim, they pour the water on the Mizbeach, by the Karban Tomet Shel Shachar, every day of Sukkot. So these three are halacha l'moshe Mishinai. Tosis here asks the question that the Gemara asks, from where do Rabbanon know this halacha of the Arava that's brought in the Beis HaMikdash if he doesn't learn it out from the Arve Shtayim like Abishol? But the question isn't the reverse. Why doesn't the Gemara ask, according to Abishol, from where does he know that the Aravis for the Dalad Minim is Lav Dafke from the Nachal, but it could be any other Arava? The Rabbana learned it out from Arve Loshen Rabim. But Abishol uses Arve Loshen Rabim for the halacha of Achas Lulav, Achas LeMikdash. So the Gemara should have asked the question in the reverse as well, according to Abishol. So Tosfos says that it could be that the Gemara doesn't ask this because according to Abishol, you must take an arava that grows by the Nachal. He doesn't have that drasha to say that it could be taken from other places. So Anachanami, according to him, you must take dafka from what grows by the Nachal. But in the Rambam, Shulchan Aruch, the Rebbe brings us in a Sikha, Barichis, and Chelich of Beis, Parshas Emor. And over there, the Rebbe says that the Mefarshim say that if you look in the Rambam and Shulchan Aruch, they darshan from Arve, like Abishol, or maybe there's another drasha, as we'll see in Amud Beis, that Arve Loshen Rabim teaches me that you have to have two Aravas. And yet, they paskin, the Rambam Shulchan Aruch paskin, that you don't have to have dafke the Aravas that grow by the Nachal. You could have any Aravas that grow anywhere. And the term Nachal in the Torah only means this min, the min of an Arava that usually grows by the Nachal. But it doesn't actually have to be by the Nachal. But the question becomes, how do we know that? How do we know to teach the Pasuk this way and you don't need a special drasha like the Rabbana needed? When it comes to the other Dalad Minim, so over there, everything it says in the Torah is Meduyik specifically. That's the requirement. By Esrik, creates Hadar, it has to be Dafka, Ador, Bilani, Mishana, Lashana, and so too, whatever it says by each one of the Dalad Minim, it's a requirement that that's the way it's supposed to be. So why by Arve Nachal do we say that the Nachal is only describing the min, but the actual requirement of Nachal is not necessary? So the Rebbe says that it's al pidrush, you could understand what this Indian is, because we know that the Dalad Minim correspond to the different levels in Klal Yisrael to unite all of them ba'achtus together in the Dalad Minim. And the Aravis refers to those Yidden that ein bem teire ve'ein bem maisim teivim. Their maila is not the mitzvahs they do. Their maila is not the teire that they learn. What's their maila? Their maila is the etzem fact that he's a Yid. The pshittus of the Yid that's connected to the very essence of the Eibishter beyond any of the teire mitzvahs that he fulfills. Mamela, when it comes to the other Dalad Minim, where we're speaking about a min of a yid that has a certain revealed specific mila that he's accomplishing, so there, those specific requirements have to actually be in order for it to qualify for the mitzvah. But when you talk about the Aravis, which the whole mila of the Aravis is just a min, the fact that he belongs, he's part of Klal Yisrael, so here, the specific requirement of Nachal doesn't have to be Bepoyel, it's just a min that he's part of Klal Yisrael, that's enough that it should be good for the mitzvah. The Rebbe also points out that from all the Dalad Minim, the Arava is the same word that is connected to Va'arva Lashem Minchas Yehuda, the sweetness of a Yid that's connected to the essence of the Eibishter, even higher than Teiru Mitzvahs. Actually, there's a Taz that the Rebbe quotes there in one of the Haras of the Sikha that says that there's the Inyan to be Mahadar, to take Dafka from the Aravas that don't grow by the Nachal, to show this Chiddush. So too the Rebbe says, there's an Inyan when you Makarav another Yid to Dafka go and to try to find, to be Makarav those Yidin that don't know Bechlal, have no Milas Gluyas, and they're just part of Bnei Avram, Yitzchak V'Yakev, to go and seek them out and to bring them in, to be Makarav them, Dafka there, there's the greatest sweetness of a Yid, the Etzem, the very essence of who he is, that he's connected to the Eibishter. Zakta Gemara Vaite, Tana Rabbanon, we learned in a Braisa, Arvei Nachal means Agdeilois Ala Nachal. This is the min that grows by the stream. Prat Litzavtzefa, Hagadela Bein Arim. This excludes a Tzavtzefa, which is similar to Arnarove, but it does not grow by the Nachal, it grows on mountains, and that's not good for the mitzvah. Omar Rab Zeire, so Rab Zeire said, my Kora, where do I see that the Tzavtzefa is not what grows by the water? Because the Pasuk says, Kach Al Maim Rabim. The Eibishter says this is a mashal that the Eibishter is saying for Yidden, that I placed them on great waters. And the Yidden should have been like the Aravis that grow very beautifully by the water. But instead, Tzavtzefa Samoy, they became like Tzavtzefa that does not grow as good as the Aravis and it grows in the mountains. So over here I see that the Tzavtzefa is not the Aravis that grows by the water. Amalei Abaye. So Abaye asked Rab Zeira, how do you know to read the pasuk this way? V'dilma pirushikum mefarish. Maybe when it says Tzavtzefa Samoy, it's explaining what it is that grows by the water. Kach Almayim Rabim. Place him by the great waters, umay niu, and what grows there by the water, tzavtzefa. This tzavtzefa grows by the water. So the Gemara says, no, that can't be, because im kain, my samoy. Why does it say samoy? It should have just said, al mayim rabim tzavtzefa. By the great waters you have tzavtzefa. What does it mean, samoy? Samoy means that it should have been aravis, but it became samoy, it became tzavtzefa, which is not what usually grows by the waters. Amar Abavo, so Abavo explains, Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Eibishter said, Ani Amarti, I said, Shiyu Yisrael Lefonai, Kekach HaMayim Rabim, that the Yidin should be in front of me, like those that grow in the great waters, and others like the Aravis, my Neo Arava. V'hein, some Atzmon, Ketzavtzefa Shebaharim. And instead, the Yidin turned themselves into a Tzavtzefa that grows in the mountains, that do not grow as good as the Aravis that grow in the water. Now the Gemara brings another version how this was said. It's all the same point, but just a different version. Ike the masnilo lahaikra amasnita. Others said that it's the Braisa itself that quoted this pasuk. It wasn't Rab Zeira that quoted the pasuk. The Braisa quoted this pasuk. Kach almayim rabim tzavtzefa shumai. That the Braisa brought this pasuk to prove that the tzavtzefa is not the aravas that usually grow on the water. And Maskefla Rab Zeira, and on this Rab Zeira asked the question, V'dilme pirushikum mefarish. So it wasn't Abaye that asked the question to Rab Zeira. Rab Zeira himself asked the question on the Braise, that maybe when it says Tzavtzefa, it's explaining what it is that grows in the great waters. Kach ha-mayim rabim emayim niyu Tzavtzefa, that the Tzavtzefa is what grows by the waters. But the answer is, imkein, my samay. Why does it say samay? That means that it became. It turned into something else that it should not have been. Amar Abavo, Makadosh Baruch Hu, Ani Amati Shi Yisrael Lefonik Kach HaMayim Rabim. The Eibishter says that I wanted the Yidden should be like what grows by the great waters, like the Aravis and my Neo Arave, V'hein Samo Atzmon Ketzavtzefa Shebaharim. And instead, Yidden turned themselves into something which is inferior from the Aravis, like the Tzavtzefa that grows on the mountains. Tana Rabbanon, we learned in the Braisa, how do we identify what's an Arave and what's a Tzavtzefa? Ezeo Arave, Ve'ezeo Tzavtzefa. Arave kana shalo odem. The arave, its stem is reddish, and va'ala shalo moshuch, and the leaf is drawn out. It's a longer leaf. Upia, and the edges of the leaf chalok is a straight ending. Tzavtzefa, by contrast, the tzavtzefa kana shalo lavan. Its stem is on the more on the whitish side. Va'ala shalo ogul, and the leaf is more round. Upia doime lamagel. And the edges of the leaf is like a magel, like a sickle, which is serrated. So too the leaf has these points, like serrated. Frek the Gemara, but Vatanya, in another braisa we learned, doime le magel, the leaf of an arava, which is similar to the serrated sickle, kosher. That is kosher. Doime le maser, posel. Only if it's similar to a maser, which is serrated in a little bit of a different way. A maser is a saw. So the difference is a magel, it's serrated on a curve, on a slant. It's serrated in a slant towards the handle, whereas the saw that's serrated is serrated in a straight way, in out, not slanted towards the handle. So if it's serrated like the saw, then it's going to be possible. So we have a steer here, two braises. If it's serrated like a sickle, is it kosher or not? Amar Abaye explains, ki tanya hahi, in that braise, when it said that it's serrated like a sickle, it's kosher. B'chilfa gila, there's a specific min called chilfa gila, which is really an arava, but yet it's serrated and it's going to be kosher. So generally, this is the simon of an arava that's not good, that's pasul, or the tzavtzefa is the one that's usually serrated, but there is a specific min of chilfa gila that really is an arava, and that's what that braise was speaking about. Amar Abaye, Abaye said, Shema mina, from this braise I see, that hai chilfa gila kosher l'ishayna, that this chilfa gila, even though it's serrated, it is kosher for the mitzvah, for the ishayna. Fragt die Gemara Pshita, it's obvious, I mean, that's the only way to answer the stira of these two braises. So it's clear that this braise is talking about this min of chilfa gila, which is not a tzavtzafa, it is an arava, but yet it is serrated. So now the time of the answer is, because the Chiddush Abai is coming to point out is, I would think, Hoyel ve'isla shem levai loynes kasha. Since this is an arava that has an additional name, chilfa gila, it's not just called arava. So maybe because it has an additional name, I would think it's not good. Kamash Malan, that's the Chiddush, that it's still kosher. Frak the Gemara ve'ei machanami. Maybe I should say, if it has this additional name, it's not kosher. And for the Gemara, Arvei Nachal Omer Achmana, the Torah says, Arvei Nachal, a plural term, b'kol makim, any of the Aravis, even if it has an additional name, is also kosher. Omer Avchiste said, Hani Tlas Mili, the following three things, Ishtani Shmayu, its name was changed, Michichorav Beis HaMikdash. After the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed, people exchanged their name. And you have to be aware of this to know what's the true identity of it. One is Chalafta Arafta, Chalafta. So this Chalafta is actually the Tzavtzefa. So what was always called it Tzavtzefa, Chalafta, is now called Arafta, it's called an Arava. And Arafta, what was called an Arava, is now called Chalafta, is now called a Tzavtzefa. So therefore you have to know that what people now refer to as the Chalafta, which is people call it a Tzavtzefa, is really the Arava, because the people exchanged its name. So what's the relevance of knowing this fact that the name was exchanged? Lulav, to know what's the right one to take for the Dalad Minim, for the Lulav. Another thing, people exchanged the name, Shipura Chatzaitzrisa, and Chatzaitzrisa Shipura. The Shafer, so you have the Shafer, which comes from a ram, which is curved, that's used for the mitzvah of Shafer, and then there's a Chatzaitzrisa. Chatzaitzrisa is a trumpet, or it comes from an animal which has a yal, which is straight, it's not curved. So people exchange the two as well. They refer to a Shafer as a Chatzaitzrisa, and they refer to Chatzaitzrisa as a Shafer. So my nafkimine, what's the relevant of this? L'Shafer shal Rosh Hashanah, to know what's the right one to take for Rosh Hashanah, to take the Shafer that's curved. The same thing also, another thing people change, Pseirta, which is a smaller table, people refer to it as a Pseirta, which is the term that was used for a larger table. And Pseirta, a larger table, people refer to it as a Pseirta, so people exchange these two terms of a large and small table. What's the relevance of these two terms? When you make a deal and you make up with someone, you're selling him a Pseirta or a Pseirta, you have to know what you're referring to, what's the way people speak to know what the sale is for. Amar Abaya, Sabaya adds, there's other names that were exchanged as well. Afani Yoima, I say as well, Beis Kossi, Huvlila, and Huvlila, Beis Kossi. These are two stomachs in the animal. As we know, an animal is Myla Geda, and therefore there's more than one stomach. So there's a stomach that's called Beis Kossi, and another stomach that's called Huvlila. And the difference between them is, as the Gemara is going to say, is Benigeta Hilchas Treifis, there's a difference. But people exchange the terms of these two stomachs. Instead of calling the Hovlila, they exchange it to the Beis Kossi. And the same thing in the reverse. Lamai Nafkimine, what's the relevance? For the halacha of Treifis, which is Lamacha Tanimtze Ba'ovi Beis HaKaisis. When you have a needle that's found in the thick wall of the Beis HaKaisis, so as Rashi explains, of course, the concept of a treife is an animal that has something that's not healthy with it and therefore can't live for 12 months. So if you have a needle that's in this thick wall of the Beis HaKaisis, if this needle is punctured through and through on both sides of the wall of the Beis HaKaisis, it's treife. But if it's only punctured on one side, so then because of the thickness of the wall, it's still okay, the animal could live and it's not treife. But that's only if the needle is in the wall, in the thick wall of the Beis HaKaisis. But the Hovlila, the wall of that stomach is much thinner, it's not as thick, and therefore even if there's a puncture just on one side of the wall, it is going to be treif. So therefore the nafkemina is to know this halacha regarding dafke the Beis HaKaisis, which people referred to then as the Hovlila, but it's really the Beis HaKaisis, to know that dafke there, if it's punctured on one side, it's still going to be kosher and not treif. So that's the relevant for this halacha of treifis. Omar Rabbe Bar Yosef, that is. Afani Yomer, I as well add another thing that people changed the name, Bavel Bursif, and Bursif Bavel. People changed the name, they called Bavel Bursif, and they called Bursif Bavel. Lamai Nafkimine, what's the relevance of this? The relevance is, Legite Noshim, to the halacha of Gite Noshim, this is the halacha that Rashi brings over here that when you bring a get from Bavel to Eretz Yisrael, so then there's a halacha that you have to have, you have to say b'fanei nichta, b'fanei nechtam, that was written and signed in front of you. So this is dafka a get that's brought from Bavel, but if it's brought from Bursif over there, that halacha does not apply. So therefore, so you have to know this halacha, that it only applies to the place that people now call Bursif, which is really Bavel. A quick correction regarding today's share. I misspoke regarding the halacha of Gittei Noshim, where the Gemara makes a distinction between Bavel and Bursif. The correct pshat is that when you bring a get from Bavel, over there are Bnei Teira and Talmidei Chachamim, you don't have to say b'fanei nichta, b'fanei nechtam. If you're bringing a get from Bursif, which was near Bavel, but it was a place of Amaratzim, there you do have to say b'fanei nichta, b'fanei nechtam. As Rashi explains, take a look inside Rashi. Zok the Heilige Mishnah, Rabbi Shmuel says, Shloisha hadasim, shtei aravis, and lulav echad. If they have three hadasim, two aravis, and one lulav. And ve'esreg echad, and also one esreg, as the Gemara will bring the psukim for this. Then the Mishnah says, regarding the hadasim, afil shnayim ketumim, even if two of the hadasim are cut off on the top, so they're pasul hadasim, ve'echad eina katum, and one of them is not cut off, it's also good. So when it says three hadasim, only one of them have to be good that's not cut off. So as Rashi says, the Gemara is going to ask, Mimonavshach, if you need three hadasim, they should all have to be kosher. If you don't need three hadasim, so you just need one. So what does it mean, even two of them that are cut off? Rav Tarfon says, afil shloshdan ketumim. You have to have three hadasim, but even if all three are cut off, it's still okay. In other words, Rav Tarfon is saying that this halacha of Hadar, that it says by Esrig, we don't learn out a hadasim that it applies. And therefore, by hadasim, even if it's cut off and it's not Hadar, it's still a good hadasim. Rabbi Akiva says, Kishem shelulav echad ve'esrig echad. Just like it's one lulav and one esrig, kach hadas echad v'arava acha. So too, it's only one hadas and one arava. Zok the Gemara Tanya, in Avraisa we learned, Rabbi Shmuel says, it says in the Torah, Pri eitz hadar a echad. So that's one pri. Kapas tmarim, so it's red kapas tmarim, singular, one. So that's also echad, one. The Torah says, anaf eitz avis, so that's shloisha. Anaf, one, eitz, a second one, and avis, a third one. So that, from here we know, that has to be three adasim. Arvei nachal, a plural term of nachal, shtayim. So from here we see there has to be two aravas. Then he says, afil shnayim ketumim, those three adasim, even if two of them are cut off on the top, ve'echot shein ekotim, and one is not cut off, like it said in the Mishnah. Tarfon says, shloisha, you have to have three adasim, afil shloshtam ketumim, even all three of them are cut off. Rabbi Akiva says, Kishem shelulav echad v'esreg echad, kach hadas echad v'arava achas. Only one hadas and one arava, just like it's only one lulav and one esreg. So the Gemara, Amalei Rabbi Eliezer, not Rabbi Eliezer says, or others are geiris of it, not to take out the word loy. Amalei Rabbi Eliezer said, Yochel, I would think, Kihei esreg yimon ba'guda achas. That the esreg should have to be bound together with the other three minim that you tie together. In other words, if you hold that you have to tie the minim together, that lulav tzarech eget, I would think that includes also the esrig as well. So amrit, so you say to answer this, but v'chinemar, priyetz hadar, v'kapist marim. Does the Torah say, kapis with a vav, that it's connected, that has to be tied together, that the priyetz hadar and the kapist marim, the lulav go together? V'halele neme ela kapist marim. It says kapis without a vav. So therefore, it doesn't have to be tied together with the other three minim. How do I know that it's a must to have all four together and you can't be yaitze part of the mitzvah just by having three of them? When the Torah writes lekachtem, it's to be read lekachtom, that it should be whole, all four minim, and without the four minim there's no mitzvah. So now we come back to what Rabbi Shmuel said. Rabbi Shmuel said that you can take the three adasim, two of them are cut off and one not, and that's good. Either way, it's not understood what he's saying. If he says that the concept of hadar applies to the adasim, so therefore you have to have not cut off, so then so all of them should have to be whole hadasim, not cut off. if he doesn't require hadar for the hadasim, like Rab Tarfon said there's no hadar for hadasim, so then afilu chad na'amiloi. So then even for one, it shouldn't have to be whole. What's the pshat here? Amar Bira, so Bira, name of a person. Amar Rab Ami, said in the name of Rab Ami, chazah by Rabbi Shmuel. Rabbi Shmuel was chayzer from the drasha that he said, anaf eitz of it, that it has to be three. And therefore Rabbi Shmuel is saying that only one is good enough. It does have to be hadar, but only one of them is good enough, and therefore that one has to be hadar, it has to be a whole hadar, it's not cut off from the top, and the other two could be cut off because he had charata from the drasha that he said that you have to have three hadasim. Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel. Rav Shmuel said in the name of Shmuel, halachik Rav Tarfon. We paskin like Rav Tarfon that there's no hadar for the hadasim. Vaz de Shmuel Taimei, Shmuel follows his opinion, the Amaluhu Shmuel, Lahanu de Mizavni Asa. Shmuel said to those people that were selling, the merchants that were selling the Hadassim, Ashvu Uzvinu, equalize your price and sell the Hadassim even for the mitzvah, even though the people are coming and looking for three Hadassim and they want to have Dafke Shleiman, but you should still sell it to them for the same price that you always sell the Hadassim. Viloy, if you're not going to give them the same price, the Rishna Luchu Kerab Tarfon. Then I'm going to be lenient and I'll darshan like Rav Tarfon to say that they don't have to be a whole hadasim, it can be cut off. So the Gemara says, my timer, what does this mean? What's the reason why he said that he would darshan like Rav Tarfon? Ileme mishum de mekel, is he saying that he would paskin like Rav Tarfon because he would want to be lenient in order that they shouldn't have to pay this high price? So if so, if he just wants to be lenient, v'lidr shluhu k'rav akiva de mekel tfei, let him dash on like Rabbi Akiva, that's even more lenient. Rabbi Akiva says he just needs one hadas. So the Gemara says, no, it's actually easier to do like Rabbi Tarfon than Rabbi Akiva. Tlase ketumi shchichi, to find three hadasim that are cut off is more common to find. Chad v'loy katum loy shchiach, to find one hadas that's not cut off, like Rabbi Akiva's opinion, that's not as easy to find. So therefore he was saying that he would pass kendafke like Rabbi Tarfon, because it's more shchiach like his opinion. So therefore over here we see that Shmuel held like Rav Tarfon, and therefore he said he would paskin like Rav Tarfon.